morning, everyone. Thank you for joining me at Saturday morning Facebook Live, last Saturday in June. And if you're joining me on replay, thanks for joining me here. So this morning, the yoga class is going to focus on our hips. So an area that gets really tight because we might be sitting a lot lately, or maybe doing a lot of extra exercise outdoors. So we're going to start this morning actually standing. So if you're already down on your mat and you're comfortable there, feel free to stay there. But if you'd like to come with me, we're going to stand to the top of our mat. So I'm going to have you come on up if you are on the ground right now. So if you'll come to the top of your mat, but you want to leave yourself some distance between your toes and the very front edge. So maybe about 12 inches. Good morning, Roberta. So as you start to stand, just kind of move your feet around a little bit and just notice the width of your feet when they land. So wherever you're comfortable, hips distance apart is great, shoulder distance apart is great. So just imagine if you were standing and you had to lift your heels and lift your toes and you feel stable. Once you find that, roll your shoulders down and back, take your palms and turn them towards the front of your room. And I'm gonna ask you to close your eyes. Just take a few breaths here and just notice with your eyes closed where the weight of your body tends to land in your feet. Is it on the outer edges of your feet? Is it more on the inner edges? Do you tend to rock back and really stand in your heels or forward into the balls of your feet? So start to establish your weight even across the left and right sides, the front and back sides, even if it feels a little unnatural to you. And now take those toes and gently spread them wide, placing a little soft bend in your knees. Now take your tailbone and gently tuck it underneath you a little bit, just like you're performing a leg bridge, but it's not a big one, just a gentle tuck. Notice when you tuck your tail slightly, you feel the rib cage getting a little closer to the belly button. But then it also causes us to round our shoulders forward. So take those shoulders and roll them back. With your next inhale breath, you reach the arms out to the side and up as our palms spin up towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, let your palms touch overhead and let your hands slide down the center line of your body. And if you're comfortable, keep your eyes closed and give me a few cycles of breath with that same pattern of arms that we just created. So on the inhale, the arms begin to rise. And as we exhale, palms touch and the hands descend down in front of your heart center. Start to match these movements of your arms to your breath. And just notice as your arms rise overhead, if there's any discomfort in your shoulders. And if there is, just reduce the range of motion of your arms. So maybe your arms won't go overhead completely, or maybe they need to be slightly in front of you as they descend down. So starting to wake up the shoulders a little bit, the upper back, noticing our posture, noticing the distribution of the weight into our feet again. And at your last inhale, when you find your arms arriving up towards the ceiling, keep them about shoulder distance apart. And we'll arrive there at different times. And now soften your shoulders. Gently gaze your eyes open. Interlacing the hands above your head. If you can't, flip your palms to the ceiling, press upwards towards the ceiling. Notice the elbows squeezing in by your temples. We're going to slide bend to your right. And coming back to center, side bend to your left. Just notice the differences in the two sides as you start to side bend. Do that one more time. So we're going to side bend to the right. Coming back through center, side bend to the left. Coming back through center, hands descend down in front of your heart. Rolling the shoulders down and back, gaze down into the fingertips. Take a moment right now to take a deep breath in. Exhale out completely, setting our intention for our practice this morning. So we gently gaze the eyes open. We're going to go really wide with our feet. So we're going to heel toe out, maybe to the width of the mat. So once you get out to the width of the mat, take a deep breath in. And start to hinge forward from your hips. So I'm just going to turn sideways. You stay forward. And as I hip hinge, I'm going to really stick my behind out to the wall behind me. Relax my chin. Come about halfway, just tap into the back of the legs. We're going to come all the way up, so you can the palms to the ceiling. So the exhale breath, we're gonna hinge down. So you hinge down as far as you need to or can to tap into the back of the leg, to a very flat back, and now come all the way back up to standing. And we've got one more just like that. So as you start to hinge, think about hips to the back wall, chest forward, and now come all the way up. So performing a big windmill action. So you need to watch this one first. Feel free to watch. I'm gonna rotate a little over to your right. And as I start to hinge, it's the same hinge that you gave me before, but now I'm a little bit over to the right corner. If it causes me to be lightheaded, I'm gonna stay at this height, drop my arms, reach over to the left, arms like airplane, flat back up. So it does not cause you to be lightheaded. You can go all the way down, touch down to the floor, let the arms sweep across, flat back up. Our goal is to keep our legs nice and straight. So hinge from the hip, nice flat back, straight legs. Drop your hands, sweep across. Arms out like airplane, and we come all the way back up. And we have one more just like that. Hinge forward from the hip. Drop and tap. Swing across. Flat back, and we're back up. Left to right this time. So flat back down. Really focusing on what we're feeling on the outer left hip. We can stay a little suspended or drop your hands to sweep. Arms like airplane, find a flat back, and we come all the way up. We've got two more just like that, so take your time. So this next one I'll do a little bit modified. So I'll stay a little bit higher. Support my belly with my back, just let my arms swing across to the other side, arms like airplane, and we come all the way up. Okay, this is the last time, left to right, so flat back down. Drop the hands to whatever height is right for you. Arms like airplane, and come all the way up. Hands to your heart center. This time we're gonna narrow our feet a little bit more, so notice how wide your feet were, bring it back in so they're about hip distance apart. And now give me a little bit of a hip swing. So tuck your bum and then just hinge. So I'll turn sideways so you can see the degree. So it looks like a leg bridge, flat back. So I'm not going very far, but I'm really emphasizing keeping my legs as straight as I can, really making sure that the bend and fold is in my hips, not in my back. So that feels good. I'm gonna incorporate some shoulders into this too. Interlace your hands behind you. Keep your knuckles on your tailbone, but pull your elbows back as you hinge. So this is gonna get a little bigger and bigger if it feels good. So notice my knuckles are on my tailbone. Next progression, straighten your arms. This time, don't let your knuckles touch your tailbone. So the hinge stays the same. I'm just swinging back to forth with my hips. Next progression, the next time I tip over, my arms are gonna reach further overhead. I might go a little deeper. If you get lightheaded, you can either stay or slowly come up. This is the last one, so the next time you come down, would you stay? Maybe you stay here. Maybe you can come all the way down. Relax your head. Ragdoll, let those hands reach up as high as you can. Take one more deep breath here. And now let the hands drop down to your tailbone. Let them drop down to the floor. Find your fingertips on the floor. And now bend your knees enough so you can find your flat back. Take one more deep breath in here. Get ready to plant your palms. We're coming down to our knees into all fours. Once we come down, move your hands generously in front of you. Just so your wrists aren't bothering you, we're gonna rock front to back. So move your knees back a little so you have room to rock. Arms are straight, rock forward, and then rock back. So if your knees bother you when you start to sit back, you don't have to sit back so far, but the goal is to really to get the hips to drop down towards the heels, and this is warming up the hips and the shoulders all at the same time. Eventually arriving into child's pose if that feels comfortable to you, but notice that your knees are not too wide right now. The next time you walk half the distance forward, can you go a little wider with your knees, maybe to the width of your mat, big toes touch, arms reach as far forward as you can,
And now slowly, slowly ease back. So if you can, drop your forehead down to your mat and find your child's pose. Sit deeply back into child's pose. If you need to support your hips because your knees are bothering you, you're gonna take the blocks, and I'm doing that now if you're not really sure what I mean. So I'll take the blocks, support my back with my thighs, and sit back. Okay, that's a little bit more comfortable for your knees if you have bad knees. So notice this morning, we started with active movement. Now I'm bringing you to a place of a little settling of your body, a little quiet time. So take a few breaths here. And just notice what you're feeling in your hips, what you're feeling in your upper body. So just stay where you are. And we'll stay here as we count down from five. Every time you hear a count, try to sink a little deeper for five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Begin to put some small movements into your fingers. Crawl your fingertips forward to the front of your mat. And start to pull your upper body away from the floor. If you have those blocks tucked underneath you, I'm going to move them to the front. Narrow your knees for cat and cow. So the knees come in about hip distance apart, tops of the shoelaces on the floor, hands a good inch in front of your shoulders. Squeeze those elbows in, and now lift the tail, lift the chest. Pull out through that lower back. Take one more inhale breath. And as we exhale, find your cat. Inhale forward to cow. And now exhale it back to cat. And we have two more just like that. And your last one's here. And at your next inhale breath, come into neutral. Notice where your hands are. I'm going to spin and face you now. I'm going to drop my elbows down to where my hands were, just so to take the pressure off the wrist. You can interlace your hands if that feels good. Narrow your knees so your knees touch. Once your knees touch, relax your head. Look backwards at your knees, and I'll try to be as descriptive as I can so you don't have to look up. So you're going to take your right knee and just float it off the floor. So right now you're relying all the body weight onto the left knee and your two elbows. Take that right knee and open it out to the side. So just like a dog, a male dog, kind of going to the bathroom. Best way I can describe that. Okay, once you have that, open it up as much as you can. Place your right hand on the floor. And now try to open up that hip as much as you can. Relax your head. Can you give me some big circles? Drop it down and around. Drop it down and around. Doesn't matter which way you're going. We're going to go, try to go for five. I've done three. Here's four. Here's five. Can you go around the other way? Here's one. That's two. Here's three. That's four. One more here. That's five. Lower this right knee down. Reset your elbows to the floor. Knees are together. You're going to lift and float that left knee off the floor. Open it out to the side. Left palm comes down on the floor, so you're up a little bit higher there. And now give me circles here. Down and around. That's one. Here's two. That's three. Here's four. And five. Go the other way. Here's one. Oh, it feels like a lot of work this morning, right? Here's two. That's three. Here's four, and one more. Here's five. Lower that knee down. Once you lower down, come back into the palms of your hands. Spread them about shoulder distance apart, knees hips distance apart. Tuck your toes. And are you ready for your downward facing dog? Float your knees. Walk your feet slightly forward. And now push backwards, drop your head. A little nod, yes and no, maybe shake it left and right. Now really push the floor away from you. Take one more long inhale breath here. At the end of the exhale, we're gonna rock forward to your high hover, push-up position. Knees or toes, you're gonna lower belly all the way down. As you come all the way down, make sure you sit on your mat. Bring your arms behind you. Drop your chin. Walk your knees and toes as close together as you can. You're gonna float your kneecaps. Float your straight legs as far as off the floor as you can. Now float the back of your hands off the floor. Keep your chin tucked. With your next inhale breath, can you lift up as high as you can for a count of five? Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Spread your arms out a little bit, spread your feet out a little bit, turn and look at one side, and lower all the way down. Just relax your shoulders. I'm gonna take one arm and bring it to an I surrender position. Looks like a field goal. Take the other arm, I surrender. Now turn your forehead back down into your mat, walk your knees and toes back together. Get ready to lift as much of your legs off the floor as you can. Big toes if you can are touching. Gently float your arms off the floor, pull your elbows slightly back. Now lift up as much as you can for five. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're gonna widen everything just a little bit. Drop it down, turn and look to the other side. Whichever direction you're looking, take that arm that you can see and straighten it overhead. Take the other arm and reach it behind you. Walk your feet together, walk your toes together so thighs are touching. Turn your forehead down into the mat. Okay, with your next inhale breath, the arm that's reaching forward is going to float off the floor, not very high. Float the opposite leg of the arm that's reaching forward off the floor. Okay, so keep everything else down. In a moment, you're going to try to lift your chest, and whatever you have lifted off the floor right now is going to lift up as high as you can. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2. Lift the other leg. Bring your big toes together. 5, 4, 3, 2. Lift the other arm that's reaching back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And spread your legs out a little bit. Lower all the way down. Don't change your arms. You're going to turn and now look at the arm that is reaching back. Take the arm that is reaching forward, bring it back. Take the arm that was reaching back, bring it forward. Take the arm that's reaching forward, slightly float it, turn your forehead down, walk your knees and toes together. Whichever arm is off the floor reaching forward, opposite leg starts to float. So keep everything on the floor except for the floating arm and leg, but try to lift your chest this time. We're lifting up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Add the other leg. Big toes touch. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Add the arm that's reaching back. Last 5, 4, 3, 2. Keep everything floating. Just plant your hands right by your rib cage. Squeeze the elbows in. Drop your toenails. You're in low cobra now. Stay or come a little bit higher or upward facing dog. Take a long inhale here and now exhale it back. Find your downward facing dog. Just let your head sink. Think about the elbows squeezing in towards your temples. Hands are nice and strong in your mat. And now push into the floor. Try to get some length in the upper body. If you need a soft bend in your knees to take the round out of your lower back. Otherwise, keep lifting your tailbone high and keep pressing those heels down. At the end of the next exhale breath, we're taking a giant step forward with your right foot. If you need or have your blocks, it's a low lunge. Bring them close to your right foot, frame your right foot, press firmly down into the block of the floor, and I'll stretch that left leg back. Your goal is to get a 90 degree angle with the front right leg with the straight back left leg. Look slightly forward but not up for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Left knee's coming down, left shoelaces relax onto your mat, chest is coming up. Kneeling lunge. We can stay or take your right hand, grab your left wrist, and lean a little bit over to the right, opening up that left hip flexor. Releasing the left arm reaches down, right hand on your waist, and get ready to lift that back leg, left leg comes off the floor, right arm parallel to the floor. We can stay here, or we're gonna twist over to the right, keep pressing that left heel back for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lowering the right hand down, both hands are gonna come back to your mat. So if you want to ease your hip back a little bit, that'll allow your hands to come down and quietly bring the right foot back, downward facing dog. Just drop your head, drop your knees if you need. Some of you might choose to stay here this morning. We'll come back here and meet you. If you'd like to move with me, you're going to rock forward, find your high push-up. Knees or toes to your low push-up. Inhale through your up dog. And now exhale, downward facing dog. Take a long inhale here. End of the exhale, left foot takes a giant step forward near your left hand. And take your blocks if you need them. Bring them close to your left foot so your arms are shoulder distance apart. Now start to spread your left heel forward, your right toes back. Get a lot of length between the front and back end of your mat. Press firmly down, look slightly forward. Try to drop and sink your hips and push that right heel back for 5, 4. Here's 3, 2. And quietly land your right knee down. Relax the shoelaces. We're lifting up to a low lunge, tuck your bum. And if you'd like, reach the arms up, soften the shoulders. Really try to get those arms right by your ears. Option to take left hand, grab your right wrist, and side bend to your left. As we release this right wrist, take the right hand, bring it down to your block. Left hand on your hip, maybe you're touching the floor. Tuck your back toes under, and can you pick up the back right knee? Back in that low lunge. We can stay or send the left arm parallel to the floor. Without letting your hips change, you can open up this left arm to the ceiling. Take one more deep breath in here. Exhale this left hand down. It's coming all the way down to your mat. Ease the hips back. Once your hands are stable, step back. Find your downward facing dog. Option to stay again, or if you'd like to take a little vinyasa, a little movement, rock forward, find your high push-up. Exhale to our low. Inhaling through an up dog or a cobra. And now exhale, find your downward facing dog. Some of you are familiar with a three-legged dog, similar to the hip rotation we performed on our elbows. You can also perform a three-legged dog on your forearms and on your knees. If you'd like to come to a three-legged dog and down dog, bring your big toes a little closer together. You're gonna take your right foot, and you're gonna lift your right foot straight behind you. So try to keep your right leg nice and straight. You're gonna kick yourself in the behind with your right heel. Without changing the distribution of your weight left to right, open up the right hip towards your right ball. Think about the right ball of your foot touching the back of your left shoulder. Looking back at your left heel, make sure your left heel makes a straight line from your second left toe. Take one more deep breath in here. Closing that right hip, lowering the right foot, reset into your down dog. Just drop your head. Rest when you need. I'm going to take you right to the other side. Left heel lifts into a three-legged dog. Kick yourself in the behind. Now try to open up that left hip towards the left wall. Drop the front of your left shoulder towards the floor. Try not to open up the shoulder. Take one more breath. Turning that left hip back into the floor, lowering the left foot. Reset into your down dog. Take one more deep breath in here. Next inhale, rock forward enough so you can come down onto your knees. Once you can come down onto your knees, I'm going to have you kind of crawl forward a little bit just so you can sit down. And once you can sit down, if you have something that can elevate your shin off the floor and you don't have blocks, grab some cushions from your couch maybe or a big beach towel. But if you have blocks, I'm going to have you take your two blocks. I'm going to have you bring them to the front of your mat. So I'm going to take my two blocks in a flat orientation and just kind of line them up parallel to the front of my mat. And depending on how sensitive you are on the outer shin, your blocks might feel a little hard. So if so, feel free to grab a towel. So I'm going to take my right shin. I'm going to put my right shin up on the block. And where my ankle bone is, it's actually the little bone, the little bone that sticks out, is actually kind of touching where the ledge of the block drops off. So you have like a little ledge in your block. So your little bone is kind of sitting on that. If it's more away, like over to the left, then you might feel the block kind of hitting your ankle and it hurts. So find that little bone and can you rest it there? So once you rest it there, I'm trying to bring my shin parallel to the front of the mat. Okay. If you could feel any pain today, feel free to adjust the angle of your block. Once you have that, I want you to flex your foot. So pull your right toes to your shin, but take your pinky toe and drop it slightly down to the floor. Can you take your left leg and swing it behind you? Okay, most of you know this is kind of the shape of a half pigeon, or what we call 90-90. If you can get 90-90 right now, hands, you're going to start to reach forward. So I'm not going to tell you where you need to put your hands because we're all a little different. So if I were to ask you to rock slightly forward right now to tap into the outer right hip, where would you need to put your hands so your neck and shoulders feel comfortable? So it is that my body is a little bit kind of sideways, so I'm not exactly at a 90 degree angle with my front thigh, but I want to lean slightly forward and keep my right shin parallel to the floor. Just think about chest towards your shin as you start to soften into this shape. So there's no wrong, there's no right. Once I'm getting close with my chest towards my shin, I might drop down onto my right elbow. I might take my left elbow, put it in front of my right ankle, interlace my hands, and imagine taking a little nap right now with my chin to my shin. Take one more deep breath here. And then start to walk your hands away from the floor so you can lift your chest. And once I've done that, I'm going to take my left leg this time and bring it back towards the front. So if I'm sitting at a letter V, my left leg is in a V, but my right leg is still kind of in this 90-90. Okay, so make sure your foot feels stable. This time I'm going to move my foot a little bit more, right foot, a little bit more onto the block. Okay, so now I have the outer edge of my foot, kind of on the edge of the block. What's going to happen now is now that my foot is on the block, I have more space between my shin and the block for most of us, right? Okay, so once you feel that, hold on to your ankle. Think about rotating your body to look to the right, and it's a little rocking forward and back. So you're not really sure, just watch for a second. I'm going to hold the ankle. I might put the other hand on the inside of my knee. I'm going to rock slightly forward so my left bum comes off the floor, and I'm going to rock slightly back. Rock forward a little, and rock back. Rock forward, so my left cheekbone just came off the floor, and rock back. Rock forward and pause, so your left sit bone might have come off the floor. You can put your elbow on that knee. So your goal right now is to hold this leg in place in contact with your blocks. If your left sit bone left the floor, make that left sit bone heavy. Can you get that left sit bone back onto the floor without causing any pain in your knee? If you're able to get the left sit bone onto the floor, now my next goal is to get my chest closer to the shin. So flat back and hinge forward. So right now, if your left sit bone is on the floor and your right sit bone's on the floor, and your shin is completely parallel onto your blocks, we're starting to fold. Openers are more effective the longer you're here. So give me a couple more breaths here. Just notice if anything in the outer right hip is starting to release. And now slowly lift the chest. And as you come up, you're going to actually lift this leg off your block. You can clear your mat off with the blocks off your mat and just straighten your legs out in front and then shake out your legs. If you have a tight inner thigh, you might have felt that on the inner thigh on the right side and on the outer hip, the lateral part of the hip, and hopefully knees are good. And setting up on the other side, I'm going to set the blocks back in front. So this is your left leg this time. So you get the little bone kind of dropping off the ledge. Swing your right leg behind you. So if you can right now, your right thigh, your left shin are both parallel to the front of your room. And once you have that, flex your left foot, so toes to shin, drop your pinky toe on the left slightly down to the floor. And once you have all that, try to sit tall. Okay, as you start to sit tall, you're now starting to feel this, possibly in the inner, so this is internal rotation for the right leg, external rotation for the left leg. Okay, this is where hands go anywhere. Okay, so hands are gonna slightly reach forward, you're gonna rock forward, and then maybe ease up and sit back. Rock forward a little. And just notice, does this side feel easier, harder than the other side? So usually the side in which your hips are tighter, you've had trauma to the hip, it's harder, okay? So this is actually my better hip. So when I'm here, not feeling a lot of sensation, not as much as I did on the other side. Maybe you're feeling more, maybe you're feeling the same. And the next time you start to hinge forward, you want your shin completely firm on your block. You want your left hip on the floor, your right thigh as parallel to your left shin as you can, hands wherever you want to put them. We're slowly going to hinge forward. Think about chin to knee. So you can hold on to the ankle with your right hand. Spend about 5 or 6 breaths here, in through the nose, out through the nose or the mouth. At the end of your exhale breath, use your inhale to bring your chest away from your thigh. And then the right leg comes forward. So now it's a letter V, a half V with your right leg. And if you need right now, you can take this leg off for a second, or we're going to keep it on, but we're going to move that left foot now a little bit more to the left, so you have your outer part of your left foot firmly on the right side of your block. And once you have that, can you set your shin back parallel to the floor? So this is where, now this left knee is not on the block. In order to get there, I'm going to have to walk forward, so we'll try that a couple of times. So we'll walk slightly forward, and then pause. Notice how much your right hip had to lift off the floor in order to get the shin back on to your block. So you can, if you want, reinforce it, put your elbow on this left knee, hand, right hand on your left ankle, and then you can rock back a little, rock forward, and now try to drop that right sit bone, rock forward. So make sure that left foot is flexed, toes to shin. That'll help you keep that left knee more comfortable. So the next time you rock forward and you get this shin completely on both your blocks, pause. And just notice how far your right sit bone lifted off the floor. Can you stay slightly forward right now? But think about sinking this right sit bone, your right cheekbone. Start to fold forward, really try to get that right sit bone back onto the floor first. Maybe it's not going to happen right now, today, 3 weeks from now, but just notice what you're feeling in that left hip. Don't force it, just let gravity take that right sit bone. And if you're able to get both of the sit bones onto the floor right now, then we start to fold. So think about flat back as we hinge forward. Every exhale breath releases that left hip, makes the upper body, makes that right sit bone a little bit heavier. So you can still breathe through this, but you're feeling sensations, it's all good. If you're having a hard time breathing right now, feeling pain, start to ease off. Hold for a couple more breaths here. With your next inhale breath, start to let that inhale pull your chest away from this left shin. As you take this left leg off your blocks, maybe clear your blocks off your mat to either side. If you like, legs out in front, shake them out. And that was considered like a forward fold. So anytime we forward fold, we start to feel this in our lower back. So I like to counter that with some leg bridging. So if you'd like to leg bridge with a strap, you're going to grab your strap. If you prefer a block, grab your block. So one block, if you're using a block, when you're looking at it, is in this orientation, squeeze it between your knees. We'll lie back if you like a strap. As we're seated, just kind of jump into your strap, and you're going to tighten it so that your knees are about hip distance apart for you. So once you have that, pull it towards you a little bit, 2 inches. We're going to lie back, and as you lie down and back, start to walk your feet towards your hands. If you can scratch your heels, that's great. If not, and it causes pain in your knees, walk your feet slightly away from your fingers. Set your toes so they're pointing forward. Lift halfway up if you're ready. Check out your strap right now. When you're halfway up and you push your knees out to the side, does it feel like it's supporting you and keeping your knees hips distance apart? If not, feel free to adjust. And I'll keep your hips halfway up with a block or strap, you choose. Start to rock a little bit to one side, get your arm underneath you, and then rock to the other side, get the arm underneath you. If you can, your fingertips are pointing down to your toes, your chin is tucked, you're halfway lifted. In a moment, every time we lift up, I'm going to ask you to push your strap out to the side like you want to tear your strap apart. If you have a block, it's a squeeze of your block in. So you'll hear me say up and push. So your push can be a squeeze, or your push can be squeeze your block or push your knees out. Here we go. Lift up, push. That's one. And just come down just a little bit. Lift up, push. Here's two. Come down just a little bit. Lift up, push. Here's three. Come down to hover. Lift up, push. Here's four. Hover. Lift up, push. Here's five. We hover. lift, push. Here's six. We hover. Lift, push. Here's seven. We hover. Lift, push. Here's eight. We hover. Lift, push. Here's nine. Going to 10. We hover. Lift, push, and hold for 10. 9. 8. Keep that resistance, either squeezing your block or pushing those knees out to the side. Lifting the hips for 3, 2, 1. And now come all the way down. Just pause here with the block or with the strap. And as we start to bring our knees towards us, we're getting rid of our block or our strap. And when you're ready, lower your feet down to the floor. Go wide, maybe the width of your mat. And now let those knees gently go side to side. Reclined figure four is coming. So many of you know this one. And we'll take the reclined figure four onto our side. So when you're ready, bring your knees back towards one another, feet hip distance apart. You're going to take your right leg and you're going to raise it to the ceiling. Cross right ankle over left knee. Push your right knee down towards the bottom right corner of your mat. Don't let your left foot lift off the floor yet, but try to get some space between your lower back and the floor now. Arch your back away from the floor. And now take your right knee and push it down a little bit more to the bottom right corner of your mat. Without letting your low back touch the floor, can you lift your left foot off the floor? Okay, the goal, if you can right now, take your hands, interlace behind the back of the left knee, and if your lower back had to touch the floor to get there, it's okay, but you're constantly trying to arch your lower back away from the floor. Take one more breath, try to squeeze that left knee in towards the outer left shoulder a little bit more. Push your right knee down to the right, but check with that low back. Try to get it off the floor. Okay, can you keep what you have and slowly roll to your left side? So you'll notice I'm rolling towards you. Once I start to roll to the left, so let go of your left leg. And now you're on your side, still with your right ankle over your left knee. So once you have that, take your left hand, grab your right ankle, take your right hand and put it on the inside of your right knee. So you're going to hold on to your left ankle with your right hand, but you're going to use your right hand and use your right hand and push your left knee away from you. So left hand's on right ankle, right hand's on left knee. I think I said it wrong earlier. Okay, once you have that happening, look up at the ceiling. Now try to look over your right shoulder. And now take your right hip. And think about taking your right hip and sitting down on your left foot. So drop that right hip away from your right waist. And as you start to ease off and not push on this knee anymore, and then take both knees and stack them. So uncross and stack right knee over left knee. Okay, once you have knee over knee, notice how your right knee seems shorter than your left knee. So it just means your right hip is shifted back. So shift your right hip forward. And once you shift your right hip forward, take your right hand, take your left hand, and slap them together. So you're laying on your side, you're stacking your shoulders, you're stacking your hips, look down and make sure your knees are even. Okay, drop the left side of your head to the floor, take your right arm, reach it up, try not to let your knees separate, and now reach this right arm back. Take one more breath here. Notice how much you're opening the right chest area. Take the right arm and reach it back up. Use a little momentum right now and try to swing your right leg away from your left to come back onto your back. Once you are on your back, lower your feet and just pause right here. Let those knees, when you're ready, gently windshield wipe side to side. And as you're windshield wiping your knees, I'm just going to spin around on my mat. So stay where you are. And I'm doing that just so you can see when we get to the other side, doing exactly what you just did. I just don't want to face away from you. Walk your feet to their hips distance apart again. This time take your left leg, raise it in the air. Cross left ankle over right knee. Pull your right left toes towards you. And now push your left knee down towards the left corner of your mat. Try to arch your lower back away from the floor. Can you keep your low back off the floor and start to pull the right knee in towards you? We might need to lower the back to the floor to grab the back of the leg, but constantly try to arch the low back away from the floor. With your next exhale breath, start to roll to your right. And as you start to roll, let go of your right leg. And when you roll all the way over to your right, you have your left ankle over your right knee. So can you take your right hand and grab that left ankle just to hold on to it? Take your left hand and push against the inside of your left knee. So your right hand is pulling left ankle towards you. Left hand is pushing your left knee away from you. And now look right up to the ceiling. Can you take your left sit bone and think about the left sit bone dropping down towards your right heel? So that's going to pull this top left hip away from your left armpit. If you're starting to feel the left side body, left hip release, look over your left shoulder. As you start to ease off, you're going to take this left ankle, lift it, and now try to stack left knee on top of right knee. Take your left arm, slap your left palm with your right palm, right to left palm touch, and now look down and make sure your knees are even. So you have to pull that left knee forward a little bit. Once the knees are even, once the shoulders are stacked, relax the right side of your head to the floor. Take your left arm and reach it up. And as you start to reach back, try not to let that left knee pull back away from the right knee. So if you want, your right hand can actually hold on to the outside of your left knee, just to try to keep your knees touching. Look up at the ceiling and just let this left arm drop behind you. Relax your shoulder. Take the left arm and start to swing it back towards the right. Maybe use your right hand, put it underneath your left knee. And as you start to swing left side of your body back to the left, hopefully that brings you back onto your back. Once you arrive here, lower your feet. And when you're ready, let the knees gently rock side to side. As your knees are rocking, start to straighten your legs onto your mat. Notice if your hips are even right now. Does one hip feel higher towards you than the other? So adjust your hips, flex your feet, take both arms, reach them up to the ceiling, interlace your hands, flip your palms to the ceiling, squeeze your elbows in, and now gently tilt your tailbone up to the ceiling so your low back is on the floor. You keep everything hugging the floor, arms are slowly drifting overhead. Take breath. Arms reach back up to the ceiling. Separate your feet so they're a little wider than where they are now. Let your big toes drop out to the corners. Turn your palms to the ceiling. Relax the back of the hands to the floor. And now drop the backs of your shoulders to the floor. Gently tuck your chin. And if this position feels good to you right now, feel free to stay right here. As we end our practice in our Shavasana, just close your eyes. Soften your breath. Just notice the heaviness in your fingers, in your toes. And allow the softness that you feel in those fingers and toes travel into the midsection. Separating your lower jaw from your upper jaw. And releasing any tension you might be holding right across the top of your forehead. Legs straight, you can slide the heel in towards your buttocks, allowing your knees to sway with your feet on the floor, hug your knees to your chest. So those knees fall to one side as you roll onto your side in your fetal position. Pause here for a few deep breaths. Own time, making your way to a seated position on your mat. You're comfortable, your eyes remain closed. Take a deep breath in, lifting our sternum, rolling our shoulders down and back, taking our hands in front of our heart, lifting the thumbs, placing our thumbs right between our two eyes. And may you breathe the quiet of the Shavasana into the rest of your weekend. Namaste. Thank you very much for joining me this morning. I think my little pal is coming to say hi this morning. Hey, Miss. Yeah, come say hi to everybody. Look, turn around. Look, say, I miss you guys. Say good morning.
Hopefully we will see you guys soon. So stay tuned. We're waiting for Governor Baker's announcement, whether or not we are able to open the gym on July 6th. So keep your fingers crossed for that. So next weekend is going to be 4th of July. So we are not going to be broadcasting next Saturday. But we'll have the schedule up later on, maybe tonight or tomorrow. So check out our website. And thank you so much for joining us. Hope to see you guys soon. Have a wonderful weekend.